Bonjour mesdames et messieurs. So, don't do this if you sharpen your photo in Lightroom. I see so many people like doing this over sharpening technique. I don't know if you can see on this video, but it's really over sharpened. I'm going to show you the right way to sharpen in Lightroom. Bonjour mesdames et messieurs. My name is Serge from the amazing, the incredible city of Paris, France, living in Florida. Let's do this. All right, just before we get started, I like to do a lot of videos on YouTube. If you don't already subscribe to the channel, please subscribe. And if you do like this video, think of liking the video. It really makes a difference. I've also wrote an incredible book on Lightroom, which is called The Natural Drama Formula. It really takes you 5 steps from finding the right exposure, the right white balance, the right color correction, the right dodge and burn, and the right sharpening. And I show you that on all kind of photos in that book. You can get it if you watch the masterclass that goes with it. It's completely free. The link is down below. All right, so let's get started. This is a photo of La Sorbonne, one of my favorite photo, and I have cracked the sharpening big time. You see my texture is all the way here. I see a lot of people using texture to add clarity and it just looks completely fake. So I'll show you how I retouch and do my sharpening. It's a two-step formula. Step number one, what I do is I go, you see the sharpening is all the way to 150. I usually look at my ISO, and if my ISO in this case was 100 ISO, I put my nose reduction to about 10, okay? Because it does not need more than 10 noise reductions. It's not so noisy. But then I take the number 100 and I deduct that 10. So what is 100 minus 10? 90, thank you so much. You know good math, I'm happy. And I put 90 of sharpening. It's gonna give a very light sharpening to the whole photo, but that's all you need. But I don't know if you can see it, it might make some noise coming up in the photo. Then what you do is you hold on the Option key if you're on a Mac, or if you're on PC, you hold on the Alt key, and then you move the masking tool to the right. And what you see here in black is not gonna get sharpened. You don't wanna sharpen the sky. So you go all the way, usually around 60, 70, 80, until you have a pure black sky. That means you're not gonna sharpen the sky. And now you get a very natural sharpen, and you don't have any noise in the sky. But that's not all. That's step number one. Step number two, please don't tell anyone. Step number two is what I called contrast sharpening. It's kind of cool when you do a big print, and this one I made a huge print of this photo, to have the foreground kind of like really sharp, and then the rest maybe a little bit blurry. So what I do is I take a big brush, and this really works if you make, you know, big prints. On the screen, you're not gonna see much. And you take a brush, you make that brush really big, and all you do on that brush is add a bit of sharpness and add a bit of texture. Okay, that's all you do. Sometimes I add a bit of clarity, but clarity is so strong. And I just sharpen the foreground elements. That's it. Make sure the flow and density of the brush. And that's it, just the foreground, not the back. And now I have a contrast between here, which is very sharp here, and here, which is a bit less sharp, giving more depth to the photo. So you get this really crisp in the foreground and everything else is kind of like more smooth. This is my advice to you. Last week, I did a really cool episode on how to turn the lights on in the city. Check it out. The video starts now. I'm sure you're gonna love it. And don't forget to get my book right under this video.